Hey, it's YAzi, and it's been a very exciting week. All the heroes have been announced, and I'm here to introduce Katsu the Wanderer. Now, it was going to be the Guardian Bravo, but his second specialization card hasn't came out yet, so I don't feel like I can make a decent video without the second one. So, Katsu the Wanderer, it's a 40 intellect, 40 health ninja hero. Following effect. Once per turn effect, when an attack action card you control hits, you may discard a card with zero cost. If you do, search your deck for a card with combo, banish it face up, then shuffle your deck. You may play it this turn. So now, I know that sounds a little bit confusing, but basically all you need is a zero cost card that you can pitch at the start of your turn to get its effect off, to start getting all your combos rolling. Before we get there, Katsu's weapon of choice is Harmonized Kodach. It's a one-handed dagger, which does mean you can have two, which is a one attack, one resource, with the effect of, if you have a card in your pitch with zero cost, Harmonized Kodach gains go again. So you can attack twice with these if you do have the resource for it, of course. This is very strong, seeing as you are able to just keep swinging with one attack just to chip them down as much as possible. Seeing as ninjas is going to be one of those kind of archetypes where the most damage you're going to get is where you start lengthening out your entire attacks to get all those little chip damage in so you can kill them with big attacks. Now, along with this leader's reveal, a new type of card has came out called Cycle. Every common and rare will have a 1 pitch, 2 pitch, and 3 pitch version of all of them. The 1 pitch will always be the strongest attack of it, and then the 3 pitch will always have the lowest, but you are pitching it for 3. Now, in the future, whenever I bring up a card, it's always going to be the red version, seeing as that's the most potential you can get out of a card. And one of those is Surging Strike. Surging Strike is a 2 resource, 2 defense, 5 attack, ninja action attack with go again. Very simple. But this is where Katsu's speciality comes into play. Whirlwind Gust Wave, just like Surging Strike, is a cycle card. It's a 0 pitch, 3 defense, 3 attack with the effect of combo. Now, combo is going to be where if you play a card before this, you get a certain effect. And this card combo is combo. If Surging Strike was the last attack in this combat chain, Whirlwind Gust Wave gains 1 attack, go again, and if this hits, draw a card. As you can see, this is how Katsu's leader ability is going to work. You're able to discard a card from your hand, to search a card from your deck, to attack with it. So in my opinion, you'd be playing 9 of this card, so you can play Katsu's first specialization card, which is Mugenshi Release. Mugenshi is a Katsu specialization. It has 2 pitch, 1 cost, 3 defense, 4 attack, with the effect of combo. If Whirlwind Gust Wave was the last attack this combat chain, Mugenshi Release gains 1 attack, go again, and if this hits, search your deck for any number of cards named Lord of Wind, reveal them, put them in your hand, then shuffle your deck. This is the strongest searching card we've ever had so far in this game. Being able to search 3 cards, even though they're all the same card, doesn't discount how strong this card on its own is. Now, every leader that you will be versing will try and stop this attack, but there's cards like Lunging Press from the demo decks and other attack reactions that you can play to make sure this does hit. And believe me, you want it to hit. Because Lord of the Wind is a 3 pitch, 0 cost, 3 defense, 2 attack, ninja action attack with following effect. If Mugenshi Release was the last attack this combat chain, you may pay X resource points as an additional cost to play Lord of Wind. If you do, shuffle X target cards named Surging Strike, Whirlwind Gust Wave, and or Mugenshi Release from your graveyard into your deck, then Lord of Wind gains X attack. This also is probably one of the most strongest cards we've had released so far. Being able to cycle probably your stronger cards back into your deck so you can play them later. Unfortunately, it doesn't shuffle itself back into the deck, but that definitely would be a bit too overpowered, being able to keep cycling through the exact same combo. On this combo by itself, when you play Mugen Shi Release and you search three Lord of the Wind, you can pitch one of those Lord of the Winds and then play Lord of the Wind to shuffle back three cards and hit for five, leaving you with one in hand, one in your discard, and then one at the bottom of your deck, which I believe is probably the most strongest combo we've heard so far. Even if you pitch two Lord of the Wind, you're able to extend your plays even further if you're able to draw more cards. I can already see people complaining about this leader in the future and how this is going to be one of those face roll decks that anyone will be able to beat anyone with. I do, however, don't find the combo too strong, as one, Mugen Shi Release has to hit, and the second thing is, I feel like this combo is going to be an early game combo, not something you can finish your opponent with. It's good to get a little bit of chip damage during the mid game, but as far as late game, I don't think this is your finisher. That's it for the video. I hope you liked it. Follow the Facebook pages on Facebook, the official and the fan page, and I'll see you in the next video.